Before you go, I have a question for you.
Of course.
What is the truth?
We place faith in ourselves. We see the world the way it really is, and hope that one day all mankind might see the same.
What is the world, then?
An illusion. One which we can either submit to, as most do, or transcend.
What is it to transcend?
To recognize nothing is true and everything is permitted. That laws arise not from divinity but reason. I understand now that our creed does not command us to be free. It commands us to be wise.
Do you see now why the Templars are a threat?
Whereas we would dispel the illusion, they would use it to rule.
Yes, to reshape the world in an image more pleasing to them. That is why I sent you to steal their treasure. That is why I keep it locked away. And that is why you kill them. So long as even one survives, so too does their desire to create a new world order. Take your equipment.
È così bello qui. This is where your order began?
It began thousands of years ago, but here it was reborn.
By the man you mentioned, Altair?
Altair ibn La'ahad. He built us up, then set us free. He saw the folly of keeping a castle like this. It had become a symbol of arrogance and a beacon for all our enemies.
And the mandate for menacing hoods? Was that his idea as well? You mentioned a creed before. What is it?
Nothing is true. Everything is permitted.
That is rather cynical.
It would be if it were doctrine. But it is merely an observation of the nature of reality. To say that nothing is true is to realize that the foundations of society are fragile, and that we must be the shepherds of our own civilization. To say that everything is permitted is to understand that we are the architects of our actions, and that we must live with their consequences, whether glorious or tragic.
The Creed of the Assassin Brotherhood teaches us that nothing is forbidden to us. Once, I thought that meant we were free to do as we would, to pursue our ideals no matter the cost. I understand now. Not a grant of permission, the creed is a warning. Ideals too easily give way to dogma. Dogma becomes fanaticism. No higher power sits in judgment of us. No supreme being watches to punish us for our sins. In the end, only we ourselves can guard against our obsessions. Only we can decide whether the road we walk carries too high a toll. We believe ourselves redeemers, avengers, saviors. We make war on those who oppose us, and they in turn make war on us. We dream of leaving our stamp upon the world. Even as we give our lives in a conflict that will be recorded in no history book. All that we do, all that we are, begins and ends with ourselves.